the Germans are in a very special situation since a long time, and because it's all about this empire, you know.
Right. But I'll say
to fight this whole world empire. And, you know, and I show you something.
Okay.
I don't know if you know that, because Germany on our ID. You know this guy?
No, I'm not familiar with him.
Stop for me.
Okay.
You see?
Oh yeah, the Baphomet. Right. Yeah, I'm familiar with
that. They put it on our ID.
Wow. Well, you see, that's the revelations right there. That's the revelations
right
there.
In Germany, like all over the world, there's an awakening. Mm. You know, people like you, like me, like my friends. Okay. Are waking up to see the truth, what's going on, to see what happened in history.
That's right. But you know what, I'll say this, right, because you said we're from Germany. Now, I'll say this, I'll be fair, because you got our people that are scattered abroad, because what this whole thing is about is the salvation of Israel. That's what this whole thing is about, you understand? But if you're not, if your line don't go back to this people, pretty much you're going into slavery, okay? And that's all I gotta tell you. But if not, then you want these people on the side, you might be one of us. You are right. You know what I mean? Because you got some of our people that came from.
I think the one of the major causes to see that we all one. You know.
Hey, but you know.
So it's no matter where you're from, what you. It's all about. It's all about, how you're thinking, how you're feeling, how you. It's about empathy, you know?
Yeah, all you, man.
But I like the fact that you showed me that, though, because that reveals certain things of what's going on, like the alphabet thing. You gotta understand, my man, is the fact that, hey, we cookie, brothers, now we cookie. Yeah. But we gotta see what they should be for London, man. Hey, the angels are gonna sit you down. Because what you have to find out, now, do you believe in the Bible?
Pardon me?
Do you believe in the Bible to a certain degree?
I believe a lot of things that is in the Bible, but there's a lot of, they faked a lot of things in the Bible too. So it's very difficult to find out the truth or not the truth, because the church did a lot of bad things to the history of the Bible of Jesus Christ and everything.
No, you're so absolutely right. You're right. But I'm going to say
I believe in Jesus Christ, and I believe in the spirituality that he is spreading. You know,
I don't believe
in religion or in.
I
don't believe in these things because I think that's man-made.
Right. You talk about like these different religions and stuff.
It's like divide et impera. It's to separate the people. They make different things that we don't see that we all.
But you know though, my man. Yeah, you kind of right on that. But the thing about these different religions, the reason why they're set up is because they were prophesied to be installed and set up to mislead the people. But I want to build this one.
Deuteronomy 32, verse 8. When the Most High divided to the nations their inheritance, when he separated the sons of Adam.
Right, when he separated the sons of Adam, because I mean, truthfully be told, we all separated as a people, because that's how the Lord set it up to be. The Lord has set it up to be to where we all want and we all get together. Hey, get me real quick, brother, because I know you got to go. Okay. Yeah, Genesis 11. You know the one. Because there was a time. Okay. All right. Yeah, you don't have to. Yeah, because if you have to understand now, there was a time and a place where everybody was being united. They were all together. They was all connected under one empire. But guess what happened? We're going to read to you what happened. So to get this straight, so you believe that there is a higher power? I believe in Jesus Christ, and you believe that there's a higher power?
I believe in higher dimensions.
Okay.
I believe in, I don't know how much dimensions, maybe 14, 15, time. Forget.
Huh?
Get and forget.
Okay.
We live in three dimensions plus time.
Okay.
So, but there's much more, like what you say before.
Yeah.
The UFOs, the extraterrestrials. I think that's reality in this world.
Yeah.
But we can't see it now. Maybe it's just changing right now.
Okay. Well, you're right about that. I'll give him a slide. But I want to do this stuff. I want to show you something on what the Most High did in terms of this situation.
Genesis chapter 11, verse 1. Mm-hmm. And the whole earth was of one language and of one speech.
It was of one language and one speech. Go on.
And it came to pass as they journeyed from the east that they found a plain in the land of Shinar. Mm-hmm. And they dwelt there. And they said one to another, go to, let us make brick and burn them thoroughly.
Yeah.
And they had brick for stone and slam had they for mortar.
Yeah, this is dealing with the Tower of Babel.
Yeah.
And they said, go to, let us build us a city and a tower, whose top may reach unto heaven. And let us make us a name, lest we be scattered abroad upon the face of the whole earth.
That's the key point. Let's make ourselves a name, so that we don't become scattered above the face of the earth. That was the point. Go on. So keep that in mind.
And the Lord came down to see the city and the tower, mm-hmm. which the children of men builded.
Yeah.
And the Lord said, behold, the people is one, and they have all one language.
Yeah.
And this they begin to do.
This, yeah.
And now nothing will be restrained from them, which they have imagined to do.
Yeah.
Go to, let us go down, and they confound their language.
That's what the angels of God said, because the angels of God, they saw that the people was coming together as one, as a one unit, which reverts back to now, New World Order. Okay, but what did the angels do? Go on.
Let us go down and confound their language.
And that's exactly what they did. The angels went down there to confound the languages of the people, because the Most High God didn't have that in mind. Okay, because it tells you that the Most High power is a man of war. Okay, like for example, if you look at how your body works, right, you have certain germs that your body fights out. So in any form of aspect of life, there's a war between them. So things were supposed to be connected and within unity like that. You understand? Certain things are set up based on war. Okay, and we live in a world full of war. That's why you have things such as racism, and you've always had that back in the beginning. You had, for example, the Persians was going against the Greeks, and so on and so on. You always had that scenario going on. And that's not going to change. Go on, brother.
That they may not understand one another's speech.
Mm-hmm. Like we do now. You speak German, I don't understand German, I speak English.
Yeah.
You may know a little English, but you may not understand it fully, because the Most High confounded the language of the people to divide them. Go on.
So the Lord scattered them abroad from thence upon the face of the whole earth.
There you go.
And they left off to build the city. Therefore, the name of it called Babel.
Right.
For the Lord did their confounding language.
And the word Babel means confusion. Go on.
Of all the earth. Yep. And from thence did the Lord scatter them abroad upon the face of the whole earth.
Mm-hmm.
These are the earth.
Well, that's it on that. So that was the plan of the Heavenly Father, was to divide and scatter the people. Because to accept this this idea that we're all one, that idea comes from the media, which is a New World Order idea. Because if you're going to establish a one world order, first and foremost, what you have to do is you have to condition the minds of the people to really think and understand that we are one. Okay? That way you can easily set up a one world system. But if you divide it, so let's say for example, if the governments divide the people, to usher in a one world system would be very difficult, because everybody would want to have their sovereignty, okay, and have their own rights. That's why they're going to do away with the rights real soon. Okay, for example, let's deal with the Brexit situation. Because I remember months ago, you had two individuals that came up to the cab, and they asked me, they said, so what's your take? Remember, brother, the two guys came up and they said, what's your take on the EU? So I told them, I said, we're gonna stay within the EU, so to speak. And pretty much, the people, they wanted to be, what's that? No, I was right about that. And I'm going to explain why, because they were still in the EU. Now, in order for us to be out of the EU, guess what? The parliament has to go through Article 50, so to speak. All right? But the plans of the, what I'm trying to say is the plans of the government is not to divide the people. It's to bring them all together in one so they can reestablish the one world order. Because if you're going to divide the EU, once again, these are still my point. It's going to be hard for you to usher the one world system.
I know what you mean, but I think the most danger is war.
Right.
Because this is and I think that has to do with the awakening of a lot of people in South America, in the US, and in Europe, in Asia, everywhere. Right. It's happening everywhere. And so now the people get the spirit of ending the war.
Right, right.
And to end the war, you have to end the war inside yourself. And now they need a new war to separate people again.
But you know what, though? I'm going to say this as well. I'm going to say
the reason why... I think the New World Order is not... it's the New World Order...